There's two bag fulls of just clothes. It's a lot of clothes. Not good. Another t-shirt. It's a typical game day. More. We actually got another bag in here. Another shirt. And then the rest just looks like game equipment. Let's go.
It's a big day for the Spartans. Big day for the Spartans.
Another day, another road trip. Tonight, it's just about a 2-hour drive to play Bridgewater Raynham in a rematch of opening night.
Yo, Bernie's getting back there.
Okay. I was loaded.
Bernie can sit with me.
No, I'm not sitting with Hills again.
No, sit with Tad right here. I'm
sitting on this side.
Okay. All right.
Because you're going to be getting filmed by Bernie the whole time.
Somebody's knee pad.
This gives me prison vibes.
I know, right?
It's the beginning of a 6-game road trip to conclude the regular season, with all except the final 2 games being against CCL rivals.
I might have to get another one of these soon.
How are you feeling about being back?
I'm so happy. I can't sit just on the side anymore. It's so annoying.
Like, well, when you're happy, I can't tell if you're happy or if you're like looking, you look psycho when you're happy.
Wow.
You do, like, you get that look on your face right there.
It's just my smile.
Like, bro. You're ready to rip someone's head off.
Well, I am. But.
Offensive zone face-offs for them, all right? So we're in our D zone. They do the pick play and they bring their wing in every time, all right? Their center is going to try to push our center back and their wing comes in and rips a shot, all right? That's how they scored against Falmouth yesterday. That's what they're going to try to do to you guys.
With the down season that BR is having at the moment, head coach Mark Lee makes sure in his pregame speech to give his boys a little reality check before they head onto the ice.
Again, very important that you understand the situation. Everybody seems to be in a great mood. You have to understand that you are one game above 500. It's taken a lot to get to that spot. We've identified who we are, and we are simply a hard-working blue-collar team. The minute we think we're something different, it doesn't go good for us. You have to outwork your opponent in every zone in that rink today. This is a team that was tied with us at our barn in the third period. This is a team that plays physical and aggressive. Now we're in their rink. You know down in that room, they're talking about getting revenge on us. Just like we were talking about getting revenge on Bishop Fenwick. So they're gonna be ready to play. You have to ask yourself, with only a few games left, whether you're gonna bring it every single shift. Because that's what it's gonna take. This game is gonna go 3 periods like a marathon. And it's gonna be the team that takes a shift off, that makes a mistake, that will be the team that goes home with the L. The team that goes out and is focused and is disciplined and outworks the opponent will go home with the W. But again, you need to understand the task at hand. Every guy in this room needs to be focused to go to battle and not accept anything but your best.
Thank you.
Seven turnovers in that period. Six of them by our wings on the wing board. Which tells me, and I'm watching it with my own eyes, guys that can battle for pucks are just accepting not getting them. If they're not perfect, White's coming away with them. Or it's going to the D. Wings, horrible period. You have to take pride in your zone on your wing boards. As well as when the D gets the puck and wants to start the breakout, you can't stand still. You need to get to a lane, an open lane, for your D to have a target to hit. And D, a couple of times through the middle, one intercepted came down, right?
No, that was Cam, but yeah, I know what you're talking about.
Okay, no.
Bad.
Right.
Bad,
bad too.
Cam was, yeah, I'm thinking.
So, bottom line is you're up 1-0 in a period that you didn't play well. So you need to turn it back, start thinking about from the defensive core on out, because I've seen a lot of defensemen now, and again, this is a team you're gonna have some ice. So get your ice and then get it to the open forward because you're gonna attract them or get it in deep. Too many times that period I'm seeing defensemen in their zone. For whatever reason, we didn't come out with our best. But you're up. And there was some good. But we need to clean up the wings. Got to do a better job. Simple as that.
A phrase I often heard in the locker room this past season was something along the lines of, "We don't need to score another goal." Tonight is a perfect example of words becoming reality, as it's physicality and shutdown defense that tell the tale.
The game. Hey, if you swear at me, I'm just gonna skate away. I swear at him in the corner and he goes, "You want me to call you?"
Let's go.
Yeah.
Let's go, Bernie.
Out there, Yorkie.
Thank you, bud.
Let's go, Bernie.
Let's go, Bernie. The shutout is Sunshine's fourth of the campaign, and a sweep of the season series against Bridgewater Raynham.
Let's go.
Couple of the leaders of our state championship team that go to school out here, they stopped in to watch you guys play, Mr. Reddy.
How we doing, boys?
Napolitano. What do you guys think? Kind of, eh?
Could be better.
Yeah. More bodies.
Yeah. Let's f***ing go, Napa.
That was good.
Yep. Dump
it down. Guys are the best. Thanks for coming over. All right. That wasn't great, you know that, right?
Yep.
We just kind of, a lot of us, just gave enough to get by. And that's a team, if you had played the way you're capable of and the way you have in the last several games, you would have probably beaten them by five. But because of the turnovers, the constant turnovers, and, you know, again, I think there's a lot of guys in here that gave 75% instead of 100%. But you came away on the road with an important 2 points, and we need to get back to business. You have a huge final league game on Saturday against a rivalry. So understand that you have to play better than that on Saturday. But again, we found a way to do it tonight. It wasn't pretty. We'll walk out of here with two needed points. Coaches,
let's get the f*** out of here.
All right. Good. It's a good after-game speech.
Got the belt here. Owen, great game. Another shout-out. Love to see it. Here we go. Let's go.
You need the hat.
Who else?
I want to know.
Like 3 minutes.
Oh, they probably done.
Rivals are rivals for a reason, and there is absolutely no love lost between St. Mary's and Bishop Fenwick High School. Less than 7 miles separate the two Catholic schools, so their paths are bound to cross at any time.
Whatever. Let's go.
Yeah, Tad, how's your state rank, bud?
Oh, dude, it's looking pretty good. It's kind of shiny in the middle.
You see how this is, right? You think this is by accident?
No.
It's all what they do. We don't like them, but none of that matters. What matters is what you guys decide to put on the ice today. Their game plan is the same it's been for a long time. Their game plan is, we know we can't really skate with St. Mary's, so we need to get St. Mary's off their game. And what they will do, as we've told you in the past, is they will get in your face, they'll talk to you, they'll try to entice you into an altercation, a problem where you'll go to the box. That's when they succeed. 5-on-5, running our lines the way we run them, they cannot beat you, and they know that. So we need to be the more disciplined team. We're not playing for the crowd. We're not doing things that we don't do. We're gonna be that blue-collar high school team that found their identity in the last month. We've found our identity. So, everybody knows your role. You know what your role is. And make sure that you go out and do what you need to do to help this team be successful. We're gonna start with the 1-2-2 aggressive. We need to be disciplined in that. The neutral zone's gotta be very good where the transition happens. And the D zone, we need to be really pay attention to the D zone, sacrificing our bodies. Face-offs are important, as we know. Centers, bear down. Make sure your line mates know what you're trying to do. Have a plan. But again, this team is a defense-first hockey team in this room. Defense wins. We're not here for any other reason but to win. And that's what wins, defense. Good defense wins all the time in all sports. So understand that. Go out there, play for the guy next to you, play for that shirt that you're wearing, and keep the shift short. But again, the discipline out of the box. Please, don't give them anything. Let them f***ing work for everything. You just outwork your opponent. In the name of the Father, Son, Holy Spirit, amen. Our Father who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. Lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil, amen. Father, Son, Holy Spirit. Let's go, boys.
There you go, there you go.
Let's go,
man.
Let's
go,
man.
Let's go,
Jamie.
Let's
go, JT.
The game plays out much like the first tilt between the two, with Fenwick forward Manny Alvarez-Segui knocking home the game's first goal, not too far into the first period.
Skate with any of us boys. We have to realize that.
Don't worry about any of this shit, boys. We just gotta be calm and collected. We're just running around right now. We look scared.
Guys, our layers in the D zone are the worst they've been all year. There's no way that a goal should happen.
It's all mental, boys.
Here's what I saw. We have to adjust, okay? And that's something we didn't do. The coach started from, I think it was the first shift on, saying D to D. And you can either, sometimes the middle's gonna be open or the wing will be open. And then we're chipping pucks.
The game remains a deadlock through the second period. Goaltender ONG and Grande is stopping every puck in sight, while the Spartan offense is continually missing its chances to even the score. Third period starts out with more of the same. Gian Grande is playing possibly one of the best games of his career, and the offense has yet to crack Fenwick netminder Dylan Bloom. As much as we wish we could have another overtime or a shootout to settle the rivalry once and for all, both teams tonight will share the same feeling of despair.
Look, we say this whole season is a learning experience, and we need to learn from things that don't go well and learn from things that go well. So we came out and literally were really flat in the first period, gave them a lot of momentum throughout that period. Then you came back in the second and started to take control of the game. You outplayed them, you outchanced them, and should have had a couple, but it didn't happen. But it wasn't because of lack of effort. Third period, I think we dominated that period. I didn't even know what were the shots. But zone play and so forth, we had a lot of opportunities and a lot of just misses. So you got to be proud of the effort that you gave the second half of this game. And even in overtime, we had, unfortunately, they had one at the very end. But we had some serious opportunities, some good work from the guys that were out there. So a lot to be positive about. A tie is a tie, but at the same time, that's a much improved team. So.
We go win the CCL Cup now. I want to beat every team now from here on out. Yeah. I'm tired of these ties and losses.
Well, you know what?
It's fucking
not cool. Because of a lack of effort today. Coaches?
Yeah, boys, put ourselves behind the eight ball early, fought back, and, salvaged a point. You all owe your goalie a big pat on the back tonight.
Great job.
Came up huge when he had to, all right? Couple big chances towards the end of that game, and he came through. So, good point. How to fight back. You guys, you left it out there.
I was really proud of the effort. Goalie, unbelievable. Coach Sret just said it, but senior leadership, captain, number two, that was a f***ing hell of a goal. That was unbelievable. We needed it in that moment, and that's what leaders do. They step up in the big moment. So great job tonight, fellas. We got a few more games ahead of us, so let's keep going right into the tournament, okay?